Let's go through AWS Lambda and make a function from scratch. Let's start with going to this Lambda console here. This is a lot of times where you'll first start out. You can see here that it'll show you all of the different Lambda functions that have been available. So we'll go through here and you can see there's zero. Let's go create our first one. I'll select author from scratch. And for the name of the function, I'm going to call this function Marco. And for the runtime, I'm going to select Python 3.7. Now, one thing to point out is that this execution role, this would cover the IAM roles. And if I did need this function to do something like talk to SQS or talk to S3, I would need to take a role and specifically assign it here. In this case, I'm going to write a very simple Lambda function, so I don't need to set a permission. All right. Okay, great. Now that I've created that test function, what I'm going to do is scroll down to the bottom here, and I'll actually take out this boilerplate code that they've given me. I'm going to take out this. And really, the only thing you care about when you're processing something from a Lambda function is that you're going to take this event and do something with it. So what I'm going to do is write a very simple Python function that processes an event. So I'm going to say, if the event that comes in has a name property, and that name is equal to Marco, I'm going to return back Polo. Otherwise, I'm not going to return back anything. So now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to write a test function that'll test that, make sure that this workflow will work. So let's go ahead and select save and then test. And what I'll do here is I'll type in the name Marco. And then for the keys here, I'm going to pull these out and I'm going to put in the word name, because that's what my function is looking for. And then I'll test it out with the word Marco. Okay, now I can save this. And now I can test this out. Again, it's looking specifically for this equality symbol. And if I scroll down, you can see that in fact, it did return back Polo. So it looks like our function is working the way I would expect. So let's go ahead and test the other case. What happens if I don't put in the name Marco? I put in, for example, Bob. Well, let's go ahead and test that out. So I'm going to say test here, and I'm going to create a new test event. And I'm going to create this new test event and call it Bob. And then I'll put in the word Bob. And this should not return back Polo because we told it to only look for the word Marco. Let's go ahead and test this. Great. And look, you can see that it returned back a null response. So now I can actually toggle back and forth between Marco, which you can see returns back Polo, or I can return Bob, which returns back nothing. So we've got nothing for Bob here. So this is really a good example of how you could use a Lambda function with an event. So instead of this event having the word name in it, it could be an S3 event, or it could be an SQS event, or it could be an SNS event. So with just two or three lines of code, you can do extremely powerful things with Lambda functions.